Ladies and gentlemen, Mesdames et Messieurs, sehr geehrte Damen und Herren, welcome to the second part of Eureka 35 years anniversary celebrations. My name is Ulrich Schuh and I have the honor and privilege to act as Eureka chairman under the Austrian chairmanship until June 2021. Today, we will focus on the creation of a European innovation area. A new inspiring idea allowing the empowerment of all European innovators and entrepreneurs to realize their full potential wherever they are in Europe. I have now the pleasure to ask Commissioner Maria Gabriel about her visions and which role Eureka may play in the EIA. Furthermore, today I welcome Minister Manuel Heitor, Minister of Science, Technology, and Higher Education of Portugal, and also Mr. Miguel Bello, who will be the Eureka chairman during the Portuguese Eureka chairmanship starting in July 2021. But now, I have the pleasure to welcome Maria Gabriel, Commissioner for Innovation, Research, Culture, Education, and Youth.
So, from the 49 members of Eureka, the European Commission, is certainly one of the most prominent and important ones. But at the same time, we are not only members of the same family, we are also partners and working together. Therefore, it's an extraordinary pleasure for me and the privilege to welcome Madam Commissioner Maria Gabriel, Commissioner for Innovation, Research, Culture, Education and Youth. And I want to ask you about the European Innovation Area. So please, can you explain what the European Innovation Area is?
Thank you. Thank you very much for this question. First of all, I would like to start by saying simply that our ambition for the European Innovation Area is to foster a fit for purpose, inclusive and connected pro-innovation environment in Europe. What we need is we need an innovation ecosystem that can transform our European leadership in science, our research excellence into innovative solutions and support a strong European recovery and transitions. That's why we need definitely to increase the speed and the scope of innovation. And second, we need to make just better use of all the talents across Europe to address the innovation divide through increased support to smaller and local innovation ecosystems. We need to support our women-led startups. And we need, of course, here to support the innovations from end users, students, and our population. So, final point, we need to strengthen our knowledge valorization and technological and innovation sovereignty. And that's through a better leverage of the European strength in science and a more forward strategy for the internationalization of startups. So, you can see we have strong assets. We would like to tackle the problems together with the stakeholders, and that's the ambition of the European Innovation Area.
Thank you so much. Eureka has always been an enthusiastic supporter and also a partner of EU initiatives of this kind. So how do you see Eureka's role in the European Innovation Area? What support can our national members offer to you?
Yes, it's true. Eureka has always been a strong and enthusiastic supporter of European initiatives. Notably, Eureka has been key to stimulating vitally important transnational collaboration in research and innovation, not just in Europe, but providing a key bridge to international partners. So that's why I'm so honored today to say happy birthday, Eureka. We would like to continue to count on you. It's true that in terms of the European Innovation Area, Eureka and member countries can provide key elements in the broader ecosystem, stimulating transnational collaboration and helping our innovative companies to grow and enter international value chains. your support and integration to the broader innovation ecosystems in Europe and beyond will be vitally important for the future of the European innovation area. So yes, we count on Eureka as a privileged partner to co-create the European innovation area.
Thank you. You can count on us. And finally, I just want to ask, what in your view is the way forward?
Well, first, we need to listen. We need to listen to the community to see how we can co-create an action plan for the European innovation area. And to do this, that will be essential first to take stock of lessons learned from the effectiveness of past innovation strategies, instruments, and actions. We have a lot to analyze the current innovation-related strategies and actions, and to assess persisting problems and new opportunities. So you can see our plan first is to have a clear process of consultation and engagement of stakeholders. And here, of course, I see Eureka and your national members as key, and I hope that you will engage fully with our activities. We foresee a broad range of consultation activities, including a series of workshops organized for external experts in strategic target groups in order really to see how we can strengthen our innovation ecosystem. The second aspect is the mobilization of broader and more local engagement to gather ideas for shaping the European innovation area and at the same time to achieve wider engagement and support from players on the ground. And third point, a dedicated website that will allow stakeholders to share needs, challenges, solutions, good practices, in order to be sure that we are not only looking at the same direction, that we are working together to propose solutions and to fulfill this vision of a Europe leader in science and innovation. So let me finish once again, offering my congratulations on the 35th anniversary of Eureka. I wish you many more years of continued success, and I look forward to having you as partners in our exciting journey to build a European innovation area.
Thank you so much, Madam Commissioner. I promise that Eureka will, with enthusiasm, support the implementation of the European innovation area. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
35 years after the starting up of the Eureka network, we are sure that we want more Eureka in the future. Eureka is a symbol, but is also a process of building collaboration and bringing together SMEs, research organizations, large companies to work together towards a common future, which is always building a better society with more innovation and better jobs. Eureka actually has built over the last 35 years a common sense, certainly born in Europe, which has expanded throughout the world, in Asia, in Africa, in Latin America, in the Americas, in general. Over the years, and through the founding principles of Eureka, the European Framework Program has evolved, particularly in terms of providing the necessary resources. But today, we Europeans do understand open collaborative frameworks for research and innovation very much based on the founding principles of the Eureka network. Actually, Portugal will become, for the third time, president of the Council of Eureka in July 2021. And actually, in our two previous presidencies, we have always recognized the unique role of the founding principles of Eureka to promote open collaborative research and innovation in the public in the rest of society in general, particularly by bringing together SMEs, very small and medium-sized enterprises with researchers, research institutions, and certainly working with large companies. This has been the main contribution of UREC to show us how collaborative, open collaborative joint ventures are the way to move forward. Today, this is more important than ever. We live throughout the world the impact of facing a pandemic and socioeconomic crisis, which call us for this understanding of open collaboration, for respect of each other. And UREC is also one way to learn from each other in the process up to which we can build a better society. UREC has also been particularly important in the European context to build synergies among different funding sources. We in Portugal have also the experience to use, for example, European structural funds and national funds to complement with other European centralized funds. And again, UREC per se is certainly a founding principle of open collaboration, of synergies among funding, but will be more and more in the years to come a driver of the recovery in Europe. That is the reason why the UREC network per se is so important to be considered in the years to come. We, all over the world, and certainly in Europe, face challenging times, particularly to make sure that we achieve a better society together with the opportunities of the digital transition, but certainly guarantee a green and ecological transition. And the building up of recovery process in the context of the digital and green transition can only be done with more knowledge and with open collaboration. And therefore, the founding principles of UREC are very timely and very modern these days in terms of society. We need to show to the world Europa and the UREC network as built. Actually, that has become very much the principles of the Portuguese presidency of the European Union, certainly towards a more digital and green Europe, certainly a more resilient Europe, but also and always a social European context and a global context with collaboration worldwide. And these are principles which have been very much associated with the UREC network since its very much beginning 35 years ago. So I congratulate all of those that throughout these 35 years has contributed for the success of UREC and certainly for its future, because UREC was and is and will be the future of the European values of social cohesion with more innovation, more research, and better jobs. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Miguel Bello. I'm the CEO of the International Atlantic Research Center, and I've been appointed as incoming chairman of UREKA under the Portuguese presidency from July 2021 till July 2022. This is the third time that Portugal assumed the presidency of UREKA. In the previous occasion, Portugal had as one of the fundamental objectives to increase the global outreach of UREC, focusing on Asia, with the incorporation of South Korea as an associated country during the second presidency of Portugal. On this new occasion, Portugal also has as one of the strategic lines to increase UREC's global footprint, but this time shifting the focus to the Atlantic, aiming at collaboration with countries in Africa and Latin America. As our Minister Manuel Eitor has emphasized in his speech, the Portuguese chairmanship shall promote the European innovation through the recovery period from the crisis associated to the COVID-19 pandemic. The only way to recover all the jobs that we have lost in this period is through innovation. This is why Eureka's role is now much more relevant than ever. Portugal also aims to encourage the involvement of the network in international initiatives directly linked with the Horizon Europe missions and the Green Deal, focusing in policy priorities such as sustainability or circular economy, all corresponding to major challenges of our society, promoting also the collaboration with international organizations with an important innovation component, like the European Space Agency. An important strategic line in our chairmanship is to strengthen the relation with the European Union within Horizon Europe, consolidating new programs like InnoWide or Invest Horizon. Probably one of the most important events during our chairmanship is the successful launch of Eurostar 3 program, planned to start in the second semester of 2021. It is also an important priority, the implementation of the new governance model for the Eureka clusters, promoting joint thematic call for space-related technologies, which would include the promotion of projects linked with the Green Deal in areas like Earth observation from space, to increase synergies between space, ocean, atmosphere, and climate, leading to a digital twin Earth, and the promotion of artificial intelligence and its combination with Earth observation system data, which will allow our industries to create new products and new markets. To finalize, I would like to recall the words of Commissioner Maria Gabriel on the European Innovation Area. She said, "I think it is time to have a real European Innovation Area because Europe more than ever needs to use all the innovation potential that we have in order to provide solutions to all these social, economic, and societal challenges. The European Innovation Area is needed to tackle these challenges. And the intention is exactly that, to complete the knowledge triangle with focus on regions, reducing innovation divide, and empowering more women on take the lead. This European Innovation Area will complement perfectly what we already have, the European Education Area and the European Research Area. Thank you very much."